Hello. My muse was on overdrive. She wouldn't let me finish reading that good book that I had because she knew that part of me was thinking about something with a window in it. And then she kept at me and I realized that I really felt like trying this paper in this journal again, putting some background watercolor on it, and I know that it's going to have the background watercolor, it's going to have some collage, and it's going to have a window. After that, nothing. But right now, the fun begins. Because I am really thinking about this and maybe this Princeton Neptune. And some sap green for starters. Maybe just a little hookers. My very favorite Daniel Smith Undersea. Ah, yes, alrighty. Moving right along. Let's pick that up. Give this an opportunity to move a little bit. If it doesn't want to, well, I'll just take care of that. Maybe a little mop up there, and let's plunk in a little bit of clouds up here. That's better. Just a little bit of turquoise over here. I don't know why, but there it is. Maybe a little bit down here. Maybe just a little touch of, just a little bit of touch of sun here. Oops. Not quite ready for the sun yet. Alrighty. Keep that sun down here. Maybe a little bit more in here. I guess I'm wishing for spring. Let's examine this and see where we are thus far. I think that needs a little bit more dark down at the bottom. that brush off a little bit and take out some of those puddles. Yes, there they go. Thirsty brush. And a little bit more undersea down here at the bottom. I need a little bit, I don't know why I do, but I want a little bit more green right up here. And maybe some over on this side. Right. Don't want to put any more liquid on here because, after all, this is definitely not watercolor paper. Want to ruin this, so if the there's too much air, I will let this dry a bit, and I'm going to go and take out some of my various collage stashes. Let's see what happens. I'll be right back. Well, I am quite off the reservation with collage this time. Just going through my greens drawer here. And seeing that's too wide, but that's too wide. Or is it jutting out this way too far? Let's take a little of this off. Maybe. Yes, better. Better. Rather than having this to frame, I'm wondering, should this one down here? No. But this yellow would go with that, but then where am I going to put my window? Oh, my. Let's see what happens now. Yes, I like that better. I don't know what that is. It looks like a scar. Okay, done. Now, I need to think about. Round this off a little bit on the edge. Because I want to see this, that. I think this needs to go down. Yes, I do. This one is number one. This one, number two. I had no plan other, than to play with watercolor. Did that. Playing with collage. Doing that. And putting a window in. I guess I'm at the window next. Shoot the window, follow the shape of the windows in the gazebo, or not. How big should it be? I don't know. A little sketching here. scissors. There they are. Why I want an opening onto the next page and what is going to go on that, in that opening. There again. I haven't the slightest. Lose a little bit too much of that cloud, maybe. Drop it down a little bit. I think so. I'd like to take a poll right now. I wish I could hear your opinions. Parallel to the bottom? Yes, it is. Well, that was just pure luck. Now, going to cut this. I'll be back. All right, mission accomplished. Now I'm I'm back to the collage because I want to see what might work under there. I'm thinking collage, because I can add things around it if I wish, but. Alrighty. That might work. That might work. Oh, we could put a swan in the sky. Why not? Flowers in the sky, or not. Oh, that one. Well, this is more fun than I can stand. I love choices. Choices are so good. This is my blue and green box, as you can tell. Closer so that you can vote. I might not hear you, but this way. That's that one. Swan in the sky, maybe too crazy even for me. Why is that one telling me that really, really, that might just do the trick? The problem here is how. Okay, this is the whole effect. Love the mountains. Thinking that should not be there. Maybe just a bit of it. More trees, more greens, less mountains. More mountains. See, I don't want that mountain peak to be right dead bang in the middle. Not the way my mind works. A little more over. I wanted that little bit of green on the other side too. Like that little green that comes down there. That puts the mountain in the middle again. Bingo. Now how am I going to get that to be in exactly the spot that it's in? Well, it would be here, and it would be here. And here. pull it out just a smidge. Put a line. That's not enough of a smidge. A little more, okay. Put a line there so I'll know. If I see that line, it's a no-go. This makes sense to me. All right, and that mountain is not dead bang in the middle. If I get some green, I'm happy. All right, turning the page. I so don't want that to move. I'm going to get a little tape. Goodness, you just can't get things to. Absolutely, off a smidge on the bottom right, and I'm not having it. Well, you've just moved the whole thing, Carol. Good for you. Should be it. Yes, yes, I'm declaring it. The trick is going to be to get these two pages glued exactly perfectly. Exactly perfectly. Back off. And that one. Right. Here's this, and off we go. Off we go. Thank you. huffing and puffing like I'm running a marathon. Is down. Right. So, I do believe it's time for me to go for a rest cure. What comes next? I haven't the foggiest. I'm kind of happy with what's happening now. I'm going to label the paint colors that I used, and I'm going to leave this alone and let that glue stick dry. And tomorrow, look at this with fresh eyes. I'll be back. Having given this a good think, I have decided to use my Derwent Inktense Pencils gesso and water mixture. I want to get rid of some of the white that is around this tree, and I want to put some shadows where they would naturally fall and see where we are. The first one I'm going to take care of, I think, will be I'm going to use the willow, get rid of some of the tear areas. Along here. And some fern green to work with that. And very dry brush, some gesso. This is my Princeton Filbert number 4. Nice fine one. This should not damage in any way. Now this is a little bit light, so I'm going to go over it with a darker one when this dries a little bit. Now I'm thinking this green might not be dark enough. This will. Darken that area. This is leaf green. Yes. A little bit more back here. Very, very light amount of water. Activate the Derwent. All right, that is a start. Let me find some gray for this, for these rocks. Neutral gray. Sit these rocks down on the ground a little bit. Let's get a little bit closer. There we go. Righty, it's working. However, I'm not happy with this. It's still too light. So, dark, dark, dark. Mm-hmm. I didn't like that one. Back I go to Bark. Let's see. Should certainly have shadow under it, so let's see what happens. Back to a look at the distance again. Take some of that out. It's a little bit too strong. But when that dries, I'm going to come back and put a trunk on that tree. I want to get rid of that. Let's do this again. All right, now. All righty. That's better. A little bit more shadow up there. Not happy with that. I want to get rid of some of that. Let's see if this is going to cooperate. Okay, that's better. Let's have a bit of a trunk for this. Looks like an arborvitae. More dark. Darker, darker, darker. When all else fails, not that one. Let's have a little charcoal. And bark. More bark. More green. And we're going to call that one a day. Okay. Now I'm going to move on. I'm thinking I want to set that back a little bit, so I thought I'd try my little pen because it's a nice fine point. I might just work around the inside bit of this. Let's see if we can. Yes, that does make a slight but nice difference. Yes, that set that down nicely. Now I'm going to give this an opportunity to dry and have another little think. I'll be right back. Well, this has been more fun, much learning. I did not know that this would happen, but it was fun tearing and slotting that in together. The background, of course, was my personal joy. I certainly love doing that. And this turned out to be a nice little touch that I enjoyed, and I did follow through on my concept of window. The little bit of Le Pen in brown on the inside of that gave it a little bit of depth. And so now, it is time to say goodbye to this art project, and I am quite tickled with it. I must say that myself. I hope that you have enjoyed watching this process unfold, and if you have, please give me a thumbs up, leave a comment, share with a friend. And I would certainly appreciate your subscribing to my channel. Thank you for joining me. Now.